Hello everyone, this is Ashijan. In this video, we will do another illustration on income tax return filing. In this video, we will do another concept of income tax return filing, that is capital gain. So students, those who have not studied capital gain yet, first of all, study capital gain thoroughly and then come to this video, how to file return filing. Because you don't know the nature of capital gain, then you can't even touch any question ready to this. So first go through that chapter very carefully and then come to this video. Now there are some particulars, that means the assessor's income arising from various heads. These are personal information of the assessee: name, father's name, PAN, address, mobile number, email, residential address, residential status, residential and ordinary residential. He was in India for 280 days during the previous year 1920. Return to be filed under B section, that is 131 original return. Address and name of the employer, Amar Textile Limited. PAN of the employer, director of a company, no. Shareholding in unlisted company, no. Number of bank account, 1. Okay, now let's see all the income details of the employee. First one is income from salary. Basic salary, that is 62 lakh. Now you know very well, if the total income of the SSE is more than 50 lakh, then we will go for ITR 2. Traveling allowance exempt under section 1014, that is 27,619. HRA, now breakup amount is given to you. That is received from employer amount, that is 31,000. Exempt amount, that is 31,000. That means nothing is taxable under HRA. But it doesn't mean that we will not do anything. We will write both these amount in their respective columns. Then entertainment allowance, 8,000. Now, as you know very well, under the head salary, if the non-government employee receiving allowance, that is entertainment allowance, then whatever amount the non-government employee receiving from the employer, the whole amount will be taxable in the hand of employee. The next one is profits in lieu of salary, that is fully taxable, 72,000. Profits in lieu of salary in the sense means perquisites or any kind of compensation or remuneration received by employee from the employer. But in this question, nothing is given that what part of profit in lieu of salary here employee is getting. So we will put this amount under the column other. Okay, other benefits. Now come to the part next section, that is capital gain, which is very important. First one is sale consideration of personal computer. Date of transfer this, cost of acquisition this, and year of acquisition this. Sale consideration amount is 30,000. Cost of acquisition 50,000. But if you have studied capital gain very well, then you must aware, as per section 214 of the capital gain, personal computer not be a part of capital asset. So that means personal computer is not considered as capital asset. So from the income tax point of view, whatever amount the recipient getting in the sale of capital asset or in the sale of personal computer, this whole amount will not be taxable. That means this will be exempt because it is not considered as capital asset. Okay, so we will not nothing to do with this amount. We will directly jump to next section, that is capital gain 2. Sale consideration of jewelry. Date of transfer 10th of September 2019, that is 48 lakh. Cost of acquisition, year of acquisition 2003-4, that is 4 lakh. CIA, that is cost of indexation, aapko given hai 34 ka 109 and 1990 ka 289. Cost of acquisition of jewelry, this, that means another jewelry was purchased by SSE on this date of rupees 30 lakh. Now you know very well that there is no exemption for this if the SSE sold jewelry and purchase another jewelry, there is no exemption of this amount. Okay, Now come to the next head, that is income from other sources. Saving bank interest, that is 11,400. You know very well, the associate will get exemption, or sorry, deduction under section TTA or TTB. TTA mein kab aayega? When the associate is in age below 60 years. That means if associate is a senior citizen, then the maximum amount of deduction will be 40,000. Let's see what is the age of SSC. Date of birth is 1957. That 1956. That means at present today's age is 64. Okay, that means he is senior citizen. That means the SSC will get deduction of banking interest amounting rupees 11,400. That means this full amount will get be deducted from the GTI. Next part is gift received in cash from a friend amounting rupees 36,000. That means if any SSC getting monetary amount from non-relative exceeding 50,000, that then will be taxable. But this amount is not exceeding 50,000, so that means this whole amount is exempt. Okay, so we will not do anything with this amount. Next one is bank interest, that is fixed deposit from SBI. Net amount is 180 and the TDS already deducted from this amount, that is 20,000 already deducted this amount, because this amount is 90%, so gross amount will be 2 lakh. Now some expenditure and investment made by SSC towards RPF 50,000, towards PPF 86,000, towards NPS 82,000. Cash deposited in Sukanya Samriddhi account. Student, वैसे तो Sukanya Samriddhi account कहाँ पर आपका आता है? Section 80C. But this deposit made by SSC in cash, so this amount will not be deducted from GTI. Cash से किया है, अगर check से होता या किसी other bank notes होता, तभी ये इस investment की आपको deduction मिलती, otherwise नहीं मिलेगी. Okay. But you need to do very carefully with these amounts. Okay, आपको अच्छे से पता है कि section 80C, 80CCC, 80CCD1 इन तीनों में मिलाकर कितनी deduction मिलती है max to max 150, and in addition to this, the employee will get the SSC will get addition of 50,000 under section 80CCDB. Okay. Next one is TDS by employer 18,030 lakh. Sorry, 18,30,000 by bank on FD interest 20,000, advance or self-assessment tax paid by SSC amounting rupees 80,000. Now there are some asset details. Jewelry that was purchased on 1984-85 amounting rupees 30,000. But students, there is another jewelry that is acquired by SSC in this date, so we need to consider this also, okay, in asset details. So this is the whole question. Now let's start with ITR filing. Again students, I am doing this whole question step by step. This Excel file is very heavy, so sometimes it takes a long time, so you need to be patient. Now we have details of salary. Now in this question we have no details of house property, so we will make it no in this question. Hame zarurat nahi hai. Now capital linked requirement hai, so isko yes hi rahenge. Then equity shares no. No. Income from other sources yes. Details of carry forward loss, no. Details of investment, no. Health insurance, yes. देखिए health insurance given नहीं है, but the thing is ITR 2 में जो sheet है, जब हम calculate करते हैं tax, तो वो without इसके आगे बढ़ती नहीं है. So इसको हमें हमेशा yes ही रखना पड़ेगा. Okay, ATG, no. Scientific research development, no. No. Chapter 6 say yes. Agriculture income, no. Exempt income, no. Again, no. Income accruing outside India, no. Foreign assets, no. Portuguese leave civil code, no. Details of assets or liabilities, yes. Now just apply this sheet and then click next. Now let's fill all these details about the asset. SSC name is Naresh Kumar. PAN number. Address of the house 86/71 New Patel Road, status of the SSE individual. Sometimes take long time for loading. Area or locality, Raja Market. Town or city, Bengaluru. Date of birth, 22/8/1956. State Karnataka. PIN code 560002. Email mobile number now this is a we will not change this part make this no Portuguese civil code no Resident status, resident. Conditions, first one. No. Again, let me make this known. Known. That's it. Now validate the sheet. Sheet is okay. Move to next. This is a part of salary. Name of the employer. Amar Textile Limited. Nature of the employer, others. Address of the employer. State Karnataka. Bangalore. Pin code 56002. Now come to the details of salary, basic salary. ₹62 lakh. Next one is driving allowance. Now nothing is given to you in this list, so we will select others and then we will write in description traveling allowance. Amount in rupees 27,690. Next one is HRA. Received from employer 31,000. Then entertainment allowance, fully taxable. Again, this allowance is not in the list. So again, we will select others and then write in description entertainment allowance. Amounting rupees 8,000. Profit in lieu of salary 72,000. So we will write option, select this and then select value of any other benefit, amenity or service privileges amounting rupees 72,000. Okay, because hame koi particular kuch given nahi hai. So how many leave any kind of benefit received by employee from his employer. Now come to the part of exempt column. First exemption is trending allowance under section 1014. Under section 1014, this is a traveling allowance. So that's come under 1014(1). $27,690. Then HRA 31,000, that come under 1013A. That's it. So now after deducting 50,000 standard deduction, the taxable amount of salary is 62,30,000. Now I suggest you to write this amount on your paper. Validate the sheet. Sheet is okay. and then move to next. Now this is a sheet of capital gain. In this you are doing a very first time, so you just go through this sheet very carefully. Now first is A part, that is short-term capital gain. Short-term capital gain items 3 and 4 are not applicable for the resident. Okay, 3 and 4. Okay, from the sale of land or building or both related to this, so we need to write sale value of consideration of any kind of land or property that is related to stamp duty value. Okay, then deduction under section 48 and short-term capital gain. Okay, and then in second point, this is related to the from the sale of equity shares or equity oriented mutual funds. That means first column for land or building that or to related any kind of property, and second column is for related to equity oriented mutual funds. And then from the sale of other assets, then A1, A2 and A3 above, that is in case of assets sold include shares of a company other than quoted shares, enter the following details. So we will need to write amount of sale of unquoted shares, full value of consideration other than assets. That means if you sell any kind of jewelry, but in this case I think jewelry is a LTCG, not STCG, and we were just going through the STCG part. So this is the all about short-term capital gain. Just make it now this one and then move ahead. Come to the part of short-term capital gain, sorry, long-term capital gain. Now B part is for long-term capital gain, and the SSE sold jewelry that come under now this is a related to shares, bonds, now you need to see this serial number 9 and read this full value of consideration in respect of assets other than unquoted shares. Now you need to write that is the SSE sold jewelry that come under 9th serial number and point number is 2nd. So write the full amount of consideration, that is 48 lakh, and then we need to write the indexation of cost of acquisition. So we need to calculate this because the CII is given to you. Now 4 lakh multiplied by 289 and divided by 109. So this will be 10,60,550. So we will write cost of acquisition with indexation here, 10,60,550. That is taxable amount of LTCG will be 37,39,450. Now make it this no, and then come to the last sheet. Yes, this one. Now assessing dekhiye kaun se asset sell hui hai, LTCG long term capital gain asset hui hai. So एंड उस पर देखिए कितना परसेंट टैक्स कैलकुलेट होगा, 20%. सो यहाँ पर एफ में आप आएंगे लास्ट में, यहाँ पर सीरियल नंबर 6 में आप लिखोगे और आपको बताना पड़ेगा कि कौन से क्वार्टर में ये जो एसेट जो कब सेल हुई है. देखो डेट ऑफ ट्रांसफर कितनी की मैंने आपको, 10th ऑफ 10th of September 2019. So we will write here this one, that is 37,39,450. I think this is the amount, this was the amount. Let me check. 37,39,450. Yes, 37,39,450. Yes. Now just now we have completed now the sheet. Just validate the sheet now. Sheet is okay, and then move to next. You just need to very carefully put all this amount in capital gain. First of all, you need to see the nature of capital gain. That is whether this is a long-term capital gain or short-term capital gain. So in this part, we need to see only the LTCG part, and then need to see the nature of asset. That means what kind of asset are going to sell, that is shares, land and building, or any other asset. Okay. So I have written other than unquoted shares. Assets mein jaake likhna aapko amount. First of all, you need to write sale consideration amount, and then you need to calculate cost of acquisition, indexation of cost of acquisition as per the value given to you. Now value always given to you in the question, okay? So there is no worry about you, but haan, aapko calculation aapko khud hi karni hai, okay? So we have validated sheet, okay hai. Now move to next. Now this sheet is ready to income from other sources. Saving bank interest 11,400. Then from deposit, देखिए FD में से कितना आया 180, but this is not a gross amount. हमें यहाँ पे कौन सा लिखना है, gross amount लिखना है 2 lakh. And then gift received from a cash of from a friend. Now this amount is exempt. So इसका हम कुछ भी नहीं करेंगे. Exempt है, कुछ भी नहीं करना आपको उसमें, कहीं भी नहीं लिखना आपको. Just validate the sheet and then move to next. Next. अच्छा यहाँ पर पूछना है कि whether you and your family, yes, senior citizen है वो SSC. देखो वो खुद है तो उसके पेरेंट्स भी होंगे, बट उसने कुछ इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं की, कुछ खर्चा नहीं किया, ठीक है, अपने हेल्थ पे ना फैमिली हेल्थ पे. सो हम कुछ भी नहीं करेंगे. वैलिडेट एंड देन मूव टू नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट, नाउ दिस इज रेडी टू इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड एक्सपेंडिचर. फर्स्ट मेक इट नो. नाउ वी नीड टू पुट ऑल दिस अमाउंट्स वेरी केयरफुली. First of all, we need to calculate the part of ATC, RPF 55,000, PPF 86,000, and that's it. So, देखिए ATC में total मिला के इनका कितना होगा, 1,41,000 हो गया. So, first of all, put this amount here, 1,41,000, RPF as well as PPF. ये तो हो गया ATC में. ATCCC में कुछ भी नहीं आएगा. एंड अब देखिए 80 CCD1 में मैक्सिमम अमाउंट कितना आ सकता है, 9,000, एंड देन रिमेनिंग अमाउंट गोज टू 80 CCD1 भी. बट 80 CCD1 में मैक्सिमम अमाउंट कितना जाएगा, मैक्स टू मैक्स 50,000, ठीक है. एंड 80 CCD2 में कितना जाएगा, एम्प्लॉयर कंट्रीब्यूशन. सो देखिए NPS है, अगर ये एम्प्लॉयर कंट्रीब्यूशन होगा तो एम्प्लॉयर भी होगा 82,000. तो पहले 82,000 फुल अमाउंट आप 80 CCD2 में ले दो, ताकि अमाउंट आप भूलना जाओ बाद में, ठीक है. देन आपको क्या करना है, देखिए 80 NPS में कितना कंट्रीब्यूट किया, 82,000. सो अभी रिमेनिंग अमाउंट कितना रहेगा 1.5 लाख में से, 9,000. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल राइट 9,000 इन 80 CCD1, ठीक है. एंड देन रिमेनिंग अमाउंट हम यहाँ पे लिखेंगे, दैट इज 73,000. 73 लिखोगे तो देखो मैक्सिमम अमाउंट कितनी डिडक्शन मिलेगी यहाँ पर, 5,000 मिल चुकी ऑलरेडी, सॉरी 50,000 की. आप चाहे अमाउंट यहाँ पे कितना लिखो, बट मैक्सिमम ड्यूरेशन कितनी मिलेगी आपको, 50,000 की ही मिलेगी. बट यू नीड टू पुट ऑल दिस अमाउंट वेरी केयरफुली, ओके. अगर डिडक्शन किसने अच्छे से पढ़ा होगा तो वो ये क्वेश्चन आराम से कर लेगा. नाउ नथिंग इज गिवन टू यू, बट नाउ अगेन जो मैं देखता हूँ कि बच्चे भूल जाते हैं, आई होप इस बार भूल गएंगे, 80 TTA. अब देखो लास्ट जब मैंने एक्सटर्नल लिया था तो काफ़ी बच्चे परेशान हो रहे थे कि सर 80 TTA में आप हमेशा अमाउंट फिल कराते हो बट ये डिसेबल आ रहा है, हम कुछ कर ही नहीं पा रहे. अब डियर वो होगा कैसे, एसएससी कौन है? एसएससी यहाँ पर इंडिविजुअल है बट उसकी एज मोर देन 60 ईयर्स है, सीनियर सिटीजन है, तो उसको डिडक्शन कहाँ मिलेगी? 80 TTB में. तो उसका अमाउंट आप यहाँ लिखोगे, ठीक है, दैट इज 11,400. मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ डिडक्शन कितना होता है यहाँ पर? 40,000, ठीक है. सो यहाँ पर उसको फुली डिडक्शन मिलेगी 11,400 की. नाउ वी हैव कम्प्लीट दिस पार्ट, वैलिडेट, शीट इज ओके, मूव टू नेक्स्ट. नाउ दिस इज रिलेटेड टू डिटेल्स ऑफ एसेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज. आई थिंक देर इज नो इमोबल एसेट, सो यहाँ पर हम इसको नो कर देंगे. ज्वेलरी, हाँ जी है ज्वेलरी. देखिए कॉस्ट कितनी है, 30,000, एंड 30 लाख की तो ऊपर खरीदी थी इस साल, ठीक है, इस साल 30 लाख की खरीदी, तो वो भी हमें इंक्लूड करना है. दैट इज 30,30,000 है यहाँ पर, 30,30,000. रेस्ट अमाउंट विल बी जीरो, वो कुछ गिवन ही नहीं है. नाउ वैलिडेट एंड देन मूव टू नेक्स्ट. नाउ दिस रिलेटेड टू टैक्स पार्ट. सो हम नीचे आएंगे, सबसे पहले क्या करेंगे, बैंडेड स्प्लिट करेंगे. बैंक डिटेल्स देखिए, SBIN 000, then press tab, you will get name of the bank that is SBI, and then fill the account number 712635. Tick this part for getting any kind of refund from the income tax, and then make this part no. And then validate. Next. Now this is ready to advanced tax. Advanced tax paid on, okay, this date. BSR 000 3490. Date 2/6/19. Serial number 000024. Amount 80,000. Validate. Next. Details related to TDS. TAN number of the employer, RTKA887. A name of the employer, Amar Textiles Limited. Income, salary से कितनी income थी? 62,30,000. 62,30,000. The TDS amount deducted by employer amounting rupees 18,30,000. Now come to the next part, tax deducted by bank. So select self, type 10 of the bank, RTKA 495 12A. Select 2018 and type the TDS amount, that is 20,000. Blank, sorry. यहाँ पर रहेगा आपका claimed in अराउंड 20,000. Gross amount 2 lakh. Under which head other sources. Rest is okay. Now validate. And then move to next. Now this is related to TCS. I think I forgot to make this make known about this sheet. Okay, without do anything, just move ahead. Son, that is father's name, Ashok Kumar. Yes, self. Now validate the sheet. Sheet is okay. And then go to part B, TTI. First validate. And then click on calculate tax. Okay. Now let's see. Income from salary 62,30,000. Income from house property nil. Long term capital gain 37,39,450. Net income other from source is 2,11,400. GTI 1,80,850. Okay, this is good. So now the final answer will be 12,46,010. Okay, so now just validate again and then generate XML file. That's it. Now you just to now you need to save this XML file and locate the path as per given your system. So this is the all about this illustration. I hope you have understood the concept of capital gain. Then now we will do some more illustration with the new more topics. Keep practicing and thank you. Please keep like and subscribe my channel.